Hi, I'm Joylyn Pringle.
What are you all doing here? Donna's going crazy.
Sorry, Sky.
Sky!
It's bad luck to see each other.
It's all gone wrong. Anyway, look, Sky, I need your help.
Why? What's happened?
It's a mess, and it's all my fault. I knew I shouldn't have, but I read Mom's diary, and now I have 3 possible dads.
Oh my God.
And I invited them all to the wedding, and I thought as soon as I'd see him, I knew he was my father, but I didn't, and now all 3 think they're my dad, and they're all expecting to give me away.
Wait a minute. Go back a bit. You did what?
I invited my dads to the wedding about 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure they'd come.
3 months?
You've got to help me.
Why didn't you tell me?
I knew you wouldn't like it.
I thought we talked about everything. I thought we had trust, but you went behind my back for some stranger.
No, it isn't like that.
Is this what this big white wedding's for? A setup so you can find your dad?
No, it's not that at all.
I wanted to take a boat to the mainland and just get married with a couple of witnesses, but you insisted on this fantasy wedding so you could play happy families?
It's about knowing who I am. I want to get married knowing who I am.
Well, that doesn't come from knowing who your dad is, Sophie. That comes from you. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I loved you, and I thought it's what you wanted. But I just don't know anymore.
You don't know if you love me anymore?
I don't know if that's what you really want.
Sorry. Am I interrupting?
No. Listen. You think about it.
Whenever you're not near, I'm satisfied. I slip my eye, I beg you, dear. What's going on? Sophie? What are you doing? It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
I don't know.
Wait right there.
I'm all right, Mom.
Of course you're not all right. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? Since when did I ever sleepwalk?
The time you came down with the measles, the time you couldn't finish your times tables.
Mom, get off. I'm not a baby.
I know. But you're still my daughter, Soph, and I know that something's wrong. I'm sorry. It's just a figure of speech.
No, that's what you think, isn't it? I'm stupid for getting married. It's just a whim.
Well, I'm not pretending I really understand.
No, of course you don't. You did just fine without a man, didn't you? You didn't do the whole marriage and babies thing. You did the baby.
What the hell is going on here? Why are you coming down on
me? I'm gonna do it right, Mom. I love Sky and I wanna be with him and I don't want my children growing up not knowing who their father is because it's crap.
If you see the wonder of a fairy tale, you can take the future, even if you fail. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see.
That 10 o'clock and the shop not open yet. It's all because of that impending marriage, I tell you. Oh, what marriage? Oh, well, I thought you knew. Why, the marriage Mrs. Levi is arranging between Mr. Horace Vandergilder, the well-known Yonkers half a millionaire, and my employer and friend Mrs. Irene Malloy. Although, if you ask me, he could never replace the late husband Mr. Peter Malloy. May he rest in peace, wherever he is. I'm not sure. He was a caution, you know. Oh, it's all too much with late husbands and new marriages. And on top of everything else, Miss Mortimer is returning this hat for the third time. Same old story. She said she wants more cherries and feathers. Cherries and feathers, she says, to catch a beau, I suppose. Although, if you ask me, I say she'd be better with a nice heavy veil. I told her, ribbons on our back is what we'll be wearing this summer if we want to catch a gentleman's eye. But she'd have none of it. Cherries and feathers she wants. On today of all days when that poor dear sweet Mrs. Malloy has enough on her mind, what with...
With what, Minnie?
The door! It's stuck.
It's stuck? Then push. Whew.
As I was saying, Mrs. Malloy, I could bite my tongue out with the things that I've said and the things I'm going to say, but as long as I've gone this far, I might as well go all the way. Mrs. Malloy, why are...
Say it, Minnie. Why have I decided to marry Horace Vandergilder?
Oh, Mrs. Malloy, I would never ask you that. I would rather die on a rack than ask you such a personal question, but as long as you bring it up.
I'm marrying Horace Vandergilder for one reason and one reason alone, Minnie. To get away from the millinery business. I hate hats.
Mrs. Malloy!
And I can no longer stand being suspected of being a wicked woman with nothing to show for it.
Mrs. Malloy!
Don't protest, Minnie. All millionaires are suspected of being wicked women. That's why I can't go into restaurants or balls or theaters. That's all the proof they'd need. Take my word for it, Minnie. Either I marry Horace Vandergilder or I break out of this place like a fire engine. Oh no, not Miss Mortimer again.
Miss Mortimer, I'll take care of it.
No, Minnie, leave it be. You can make another hat for Miss Mortimer if you like. I'm wearing this one myself.
Mrs. Malloy, you can't. You're a widow. And that hat, it's provocative, that's what it is.
Is it, Minnie? Well, who knows who may walk into the shop today. And provocative may be just what I want to be.
Mrs. Malloy.